today. From Nissan Stadium in Nashville, Tennessee, this is the National Football League. We'll see Ryan Tannehill and the Tennessee Titans taking on Deshaun Watson and the Houston Texans.
By many accounts, one of the most underrated home venues in all of the NFL resides in the heart of Nashville, Tennessee, and that's where we find ourselves at Nissan Stadium. This crowd here fired up for football as a moment ago their Titans were introduced. This should be a good one as the Titans get set to match up with the Houston Texans. Tucker McCann now set to do the honors here, and we are underway from Nashville. On the return, Andre Roberts from his end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, had he opted for the touchback. The Texans ready to take over here on offense, and it's Deshaun Watson at the controls in his fifth season now in the NFL.
Another tremendous year in 2020 where he led the NFL with 4,823 passing yards. And remember, that was in a year after DeAndre Hopkins was traded to Arizona. Also had 33 touchdown passes against only 7 interceptions. A dynamic performer.
On 1st and 10, Watson. And Cooks has it over the middle. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
They'll run for the first time with Philip Lindsay.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a 3rd and 5. Watson now to throw. And that's complete to Cooks. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. A nice pickup of 10 means that this drive will stay on track. And he's already got 2 catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball. And sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on.
On 1st and 10, it's Lindsay. Rashawn Evans out of Alabama had the tackle defensively.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Throwing on 2nd and 8, Watson. It's complete to Chris Conley. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 39. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another first.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. So operating from Tennessee territory now, here's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. A shotgun snap for Watson. That's caught by his tight end, Jordan Akins. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Their confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sidelines thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
From the red zone now, Watson. He finds his man, Johnson. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first.
Good call there on first down. And Brandon, I'm getting better over the years at not screaming out screen, screen, screen with my defensive training. They want to keep those pass rushers honest, and they did so there, and they wind up picking up positive yardage.
To throw again on second down, Watson, and they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. It's Jeffrey Simmons that time who got in to record the sack.
And just 19 sacks as a team last year, the third lowest in the NFL. Yet this team still made the playoffs. With better pass rushes we just saw there, this team could have a longer stay as they seek a Super Bowl title.
Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. Out of the gun, Watson. And he's got it. Touchdown, Texans. It's Deshaun Watson with a touchdown pass to Brandon Cooks. And the Texans take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. The underdog here is showing no fear. Great opening drive.
Now, we weren't in the locker room for the pregame speech, but I will guarantee you, somewhere along the way, the head coach said, let's just grab a big stick and smack them with it and let them know we're going to be here today. They may be the team that's supposed to be superior, but we're not backing down to anyone.
And on the road, no less, setting the tone. Kaimi Fairbairn on for the extra point. And the Texans take a 7-0 lead. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it results in the Texans finding the end zone. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him 3 more. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. And the holding penalty sets them back inside the 20 as they get going on this drive. On first and 10, Tannehill. Got his man. That's the Pro Bowler, Julio Jones. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
Right here, 20.
On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Tannehill going to turn and give this to Henry. It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd-and-2 situation.
All right, Brent, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
The Texans here on 3rd down, putting an extra defender in the secondary. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And this is going to be a Titans 1st down as good running gets him to about the 44.
Get me! Let's go! Let's go!
After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. A pair of 1st downs gives him a 1st and 10 up at the 44. Henry running right. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Just a yard on the 1st down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
You know, it's not just all athleticism from defensive linemen. Let's give them a little credit for their football intelligence as well. Read and react by them, understood the play call, and stacked it up and stuffed the run.
On 2nd down, here's Henry. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Give him 16 yards there, a Tennessee 1st down.
And Derrick Henry with the ball in his hands, what a sight to behold, because power and speed involved in every touch for him. Coming off another spectacular season with the Titans, he became the first since LaDainian Tomlinson in 2006 and 2007 to win 2 straight rushing titles, and he did it with style, too. Just the 8th man to top 2,000 yards, and the 1st since Adrian Peterson in 2012. He has his sights set on another 2,000-yard season.
A 1st down carry for Henry. He was brought down by Kamu Grugier-Hill.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
The 1st down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. They'll try the air now with Tannehill. And his throw here is incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver, and it's 3rd and 5. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
Out of the gun, Tannehill. 1st down and much more here for Jones. And finally, taken down at the 15. The Titans efficient passing on this drive. There's another 1st down.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Two minutes gone by, 2nd quarter. They'll run on 1st down. It's Henry. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11.
Zach Cunningham, league's leading tackler a year ago, in to make the stop.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
That catch good for five. It's third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
They'll look to make it 3 for 3 on third down conversions. They need a yard here. To throw is Tannehill. And that is incomplete. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was third and short, okay? They decided to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
McCann's kick up and good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So from an offensive perspective, at least able to get on the board here right in front of the two-minute warning.
Yeah, now it's time to talk about complimentary football, isn't it? Because if the defense can force a three and out, there could be enough time on the clock that they can get the ball back for their offensive guys and maybe put some more points on the board before the half.
McCann's got it teed up. On the return, Andre Roberts from his end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. So now we get set to see Houston for their second drive of the ball game. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their own 24. He'll start things with a handoff to Lindsey. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, give him 14.
And that was a pleasing run from Philip Lindsay coming over from the Denver Broncos to join now a crowded backfield with the Houston Texans. But why is it so crowded? Because they finished 31st in the league last year in rushing, and they're trying to find anyone who can lead them and get that running game moving in Houston.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They stay on the ground. This time it's Johnson. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. Give him 4 yards on the play, and that will lead us into the two-minute warning. 2 minutes to play in this first half, 7-3, our score. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Under pressure now, Watson, and down he goes. Jeffrey Simmons picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
And this offensive line, as we all remember, allowed 50 sacks last year, tied for the second most in the NFL. They've vowed new techniques, a few new players, but so far, not quite getting it done.
Gonna need something special here on third and long. After that sack, what does Watson have in his arsenal? Here's Watson. Out to his left. He's got... Oh, the ball is out. Watson lost it. It's picked up by the Titans. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Good job starting on that scramble. Had his eyes on that first down marker, CD, but lost the most important thing, the football.
Yeah, wasn't quite there. Focused solely on getting to the first down marker. Forgot to cover up and take care of the ball.
Derrick Henry and the rest of the Titans offense about ready to roll again.
He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here.
First down, Titans, gain of 12.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Here's Tannehill. That's complete to his tight end, Ferkser. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Here's Tannehill. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one.
Second and two.
From the gun, here's Tannehill. Got a man, it's Brown.
And the Titans are going to be set up with a first and goal here as the tackle made at the nine. Tannehill to his top target, Brown, for a Tennessee first.
A.J. Brown is starting to get a well-deserved reputation as one of the top-flight receivers in the NFL. Went over 1,000 yards in his first 2 years. Makes another strong catch there.
Now Tannehill. This will be caught once again by Brown. And from the nine, they get this to the 5 yard line. Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. So second and goal, and the big man Henry alone in the backfield. Throwing again is Tannehill. Being chased, and he will score! Touchdown, Titans! Ryan Tannehill, as the first half is winding down, and the Titans have taken the lead.
That could be an important swing right there. A touchdown in the final minute of the half to take the lead.
And I like the point you just made there. Could be an important swing because now that they have the lead, if they can carry that into the locker room at the half, they'll feel really good about what they accomplished in the first two quarters.
Tucker McCann now for the extra point.
It's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. That time, a six-play drive, and it's finished off with a 5-yard touchdown run.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
Andre Roberts now to return it.
And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything.
They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
End result of that one, a nice 4-yard gain. So you can use that to set up your play action game. Or you can come right back and continue to run the football, because as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls.
The final shot before the break, Watson. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we've reached halftime here in Nashville, the Music City, with the Titans out in front. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. We saw a strong first half from our quarterback. His guys lead, though by only a field goal. Still anybody's game. As we send it back to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. Hold the lead, and they'll get the football first as the third quarter gets underway.
Taking it about the 1. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
The Titans getting set to go here to begin the third quarter. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. Tannehill on first down. Man open, here is Jones. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20.
As they began this drive, I was wondering how they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
They couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one score game, first and 10 here.
Tannehill.
And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
He was trying to get it to A.J. Brown that time. That'll bring up second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Draw play. This is Henry. And very little running room there. He did get a couple up to the 49.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Good.
And the Texans have an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Tannehill now to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. So it would appear they will not be able to add to their lead on this opening drive of the second half.
Yeah, if another touchdown was scored there, now we're talking about a two-score game, and they're probably on their way of creating an excellent gap between them and their pursuers. But how about the defense there able to step up and keep themselves in this one?
He gets us away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds, and they spotted it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. So here's the Texans offense now. They get set to start this third quarter. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again is Watson. Throw right side into the hands of Akins. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
First down, Lindsey, and this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Watson to give. This is Johnson. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they're left with a third and 8.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Throwing on third down, Watson. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Jeffrey Simmons, who else? He's in there for his fourth sack of the afternoon.
And, of course, that's not an easy man to sack. You know how elusive he can be trying to get outside of the pocket. That was a great play on the defensive side.
And I wonder what was going through his mind because he didn't seem as committed to using his legs to pick up yardage. He wanted to keep that play alive, so either take off and go or throw it away. But he held on to the football and ended up getting sacked.
Here's Cameron Johnston now as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the 5, all the way down at the 2-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. And they will begin with, should we call it, far from ideal starting field position, their own 2-yard line.
So what's your definition of ideal?
the 1 yard line on the other side of the field.
Yes, exactly right. Yeah. So yes, your definition is apropos in this case.
They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he's able to get him a small cushion before being taken down at the 5, a gain of 3.
And while they hope to continue this drive, it's really already mission accomplished. They've given enough space now that if they have to punt the ball, they've done so with that first run.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. They'll run it again with Henry. And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting 3rd and about 4 to go.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Here's Tannehill. This pass complete to Reynolds. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Tannehill hooking up with Reynolds for a Titan first.
Well, they were backed up to start the drive, but how about that aggressiveness? Firing it downfield right away. Nice job there getting out towards what would have been their normal starting position.
First down, it's Tannehill. This will be caught by Brown. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 11 more on that one and another first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. A good action to this point in the 3rd quarter, just a 3-point game, 2nd and 10. Running from the gun with Henry. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a 3rd down.
That 2nd down play call was not to pick up the 1st down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable 3rd down because they had incompletion on 1st down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Throwing on 3rd down, Tannehill. Toward the sideline, did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a 1st down. So the scoring dried up here in the 3rd. Nothing that quarter for either side. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So a 1st and 10 now in Houston territory at the 38. A shotgun handoff to Henry. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. 71 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front 7, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing, slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
Absolutely.
go. Ready? Watch the pass.
Get the end, boys. Get the end. Get the end. From the red zone now, Tannehill. He's got the tight end, Ferkser, right side complete.
A gain of 6 there on first. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. He's got it over the middle to Jeff Swaim. And the Titans are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. First target, first catch, and a first down.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Tannehill. Going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line.
The first and goal looked like things were set up nicely, and now all of a sudden on second and goal, Charles, a big challenge ahead of them.
And you have to know when you're this close to the goal line, things are going to happen faster, so you've got to get the ball out quick. Not going to have much time in the pocket before the defenders bring pressure.
So first down went in the wrong direction. They're at the 13-yard line. Here's second and goal. Now Tannehill. Quick hitter here. It's complete. They'll wind up getting 7 on the completion, but they'll still be faced now with a third and goal situation.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Now Tannehill on third and goal. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. So decision time now, because a field goal keeps it a 1-score game. What are you thinking?
Well, I'm looking at the down and distance, and that's where the issue comes in. It's not short enough that it's a no-brainer and you go for it. You have to analyze this one. To me, you take the field goal, take the points. I don't think you want to risk coming away with nothing.
McCann's kick is good.
And the lead stretches to 6 here. It's 13-7. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, it's a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down.
McCann's got it teed up. On the return, Andre Roberts from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
And now out comes Houston. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their own 23. It's Watson. His throw incomplete.
That was a nice job defensively of disguising their coverage and making it difficult for the quarterback to lock in on a receiver, and it results in an incomplete pass.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Watson. Good footwork at the 30. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third. They'll try and run for it with Lindsey. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Back to throw, Watson. That's complete to the Memphis man, Anthony Miller. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Pass complete from Watson to Akins. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. First down now, but that clock rolling. Watson rolling to his right, and he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. This defense, they just continue to feast. 5 sacks now as a unit. It's been quite an afternoon getting to the quarterback.
And we're seeing it come from a variety of places as well. Sometimes just the guys up front getting to them. Other times you add extra guys rushing the quarterback, twists and stunts. It's been a variety, and they've had no way of blocking them.
That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
And remember, field goal does them no good in this situation.
You got to think they should be taking some shots for the end zone soon. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also 3rd down. Now Watson. And Cooks hands it over the middle. And he is going to have a Texans 1st down, and he's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on 3rd and 2. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. There's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. To throw, Watson. And that is caught. Touchdown. And they're an extra point away from taking the lead here in the final minute. They got the dramatic score to tie the game here late 4th quarter. Now all eyes resting on the foot of one man.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And your brother called me before the game. That's his guy in fantasy. He needs this one badly.
So they're not home yet. Still a critical extra point here to break the tie. And they have got the lead. So a nice drive put together there. They go 75 yards in 9 plays. And the result, a Houston touchdown. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away.
From the six. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. So now Tannehill and the Titans trailing 14-13, 24 seconds to go. And they need about 35 yards to get in range for a winner as they come up on first down. Now Tannehill. He's got Furkser, and he'll get him a first down up past the 40 as the clock ticks on. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds remaining. Here's Tannehill. Gets this to Furkser, the tight end. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as he'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. Second and 11. Tannehill to Henry, and he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
One last throw here for Tannehill. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Vernon Hargraves with a pick. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. Well, we were on hand for a fun and entertaining game here, coming down really to that last play. Great job defensively to get the pick and seal it.
And we know that every play during a game matters. You're never sure which one's going to be one of the key ones. But at the end of the game, when you analyze it, three, four, five plays are going to be the ones you focus on. And that last play was one of them. The last shot, had to take it, and they came up with the interception and sealed their victory.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that.